Assalamu alaikum. In this tutorial, we will learn how to move a character or an object on a waypoint. So I have this simple scene available with the plan. Now let's create a cube which will follow the path. So this is our cube, and let's make a path using some waypoints, like for example creating some spheres in a specific direction. So now we have this specific random path. Let's just resize it. Now we have this example path available, and our cube will walk on these waypoints. Now let's go to our object that we want to move and create a script called move on waypoints. So the first thing we want, the array of object which will be our waypoints. And now we will require to assign our waypoints here. So let's lock it, the inspector, and move over the sphere points here. So now our all the points are available here. Let's open the script again, and we just need to write a logic that our current cube follow this waypoint. So let's create an update method here. Then use the vector theme method, which is called move towards get current position of the transform, and then the next point here. Should be 0 at starting. We will pick the first point, and this should be the position, and the max distance delta. This is something the distance that you want to move using protocol. You can also consider it the speed of movement. So let's put 2 here. And instead to, we should write a public variable of float called speed, so we can manually adjust it on the inspector according to our needs, and make sure to multiply it time to delta time. And now we will get the new position after the move towards calculation. So it will return us a new vector 3. Let's make a vector 3 here. New boss, new position, and then we will just set this transform position to let's run this to see that how this work, and set up a camera in the same place again. First logic we have created successfully, that we can move to the first element. Now we want to iterate to the next waypoint, because it should not stop here. So let's create a logic of distance. So we should have the vector 3 again with the distance, and now we will get the waypoint index separately. So let's call it vector 3 or destination, and just put this line here and move this destination here. Now we'll get the transform with position comma the destination, and we will call vector 3 distance. This will return a distance of this two matrix, sorry, it should be a float. So we will get the distance of current position and the destination point. And if this destination point is less than or equal to 0.05 and something like this, then we will just increment this index. And we should point this on top, so it should not reset in the next object cycle. Now if it will learn the logic of move towards, then on all frame it will check the distance. If it goes below 0.05, distance is below a specific threshold, then increment the index and our waypoint new destination will be up to. See that how it works. It's working fine. You've got a scene view and you can see that. And in the final frame, we get this index out of range error, which is in that it goes far past the index. So we just make another condition that if is less than the waypoints count, I'm going to speed up. So now we will get no error. One bonus tip is that you can add one more variable to allow the looping rule. Let's make it true. So if it reaches to the final destination, it will go inside else and we can reset index to 0. But before this, you want to check that if is loop is enabled. So if it's loop, then it will go back to the first position and then the cycle will continue. Is loop is enabled, and let's make it a bit faster, and you can see that it's going again on the first position. And we can even make it more faster. And we can even make it smaller, slower. So thanks for watching. I hope this simple code will help you to move your character on a specific position. You can replace this game object with directly the positions and it will work fine. So thank you for watching.